Our atmosphere is vital to all living things on our planet. So how much do you know about the air we breathe? Air pollution occurs in the air. It can easily travel and spread, and because we breathe in air, we cannot easily avoid it. Today we are going to learn about all air pollution and prevention intervention that is needed on everyone's part to address this big problem that is unhealthy for life on Earth. Hi, I'm here with Sarah Goodwin. Sarah, what is air pollution?
Air pollution occurs when there are harmful substances in our air, such as gases or chemicals. Air pollution is an important issue because it affects all of us, even our plants and our food sources. Our main air pollution problem in this region is ground level ozone, and ground level ozone is created from emissions from cars, plants, factories, even household chemicals that cook in our summertime sunlight and form what's called ground level ozone.
What is good ozone versus bad ozone?
Well, good ozone is the ozone layer high up above us. It's the layer that protects us from the ultraviolet rays of the sun. The bad ozone layer is what we're talking about today, ground level ozone, and that's right here with us. It's the air we breathe, and it can be harmful to our lungs.
One of the effects of air pollution we hear about a lot is ground level ozone. This may surprise you, but our actions are responsible for it.
Typical ozone season is June 1st through August 31st. That's when we see the most high ozone days, but we also see some high days in May and September. Ground level ozone is measured and forecasted by air quality meteorologists, and they do this by looking at the weather conditions and all the emission sources from cars, trucks, factories, and plants. Well, on high ozone days, the Colorado Department of Public Health and Environment and the Regional Air Quality Council issue ozone alerts. So you might see ozone alerts on the highway message boards as you're driving. You might get an email from the Regional Air Quality Council or the Department of Health, and you might get a text. We actually are under an ozone action alert today, which means the ozone levels could be high today. So when that happens, we tell people to exercise indoors and to do what they can to decrease ozone levels. And the best thing for that is to decrease their driving. If there's an ozone alert, that means that the air quality meteorologists are forecasting a high ozone day, which means the levels of ozone in the air are high. It means that it can affect healthy people, it can affect the elderly, the young, it can affect everyone. Well, ozone can trigger attacks and symptoms in individuals with pre-existing health conditions, such as asthma or other respiratory conditions. Ozone can also cause things in healthy people, things like difficulty breathing, eye irritation, and even reduced resistance to lung infections and colds.
There are certain standards our air needs to meet to be safe for all Coloradans to breathe, and we don't always meet those standards. So what can we do to make Colorado's air better?
We designed a game that's for kids. So instead of driving cars, the kids are riding tricycles around a course, and they're completing errand stops. They're going to the candy shop, the toy store, and the sports store. The game is designed to show how people can combine their car trips into one trip instead of multiple trips. So we can all combine our car trips. If you combine your errands into one trip, you're driving less each week, and that really makes a positive impact on our air quality.
Does public transportation help?
Public transportation helps a lot because it's taking cars off the road. The Denver metro area has a lot of variety in public transportation, such as the bus and light rail.
What about electric vehicles?
Electric vehicles have no emissions, so they are very clean for our air, and they're also really fun to drive and ride in.
What other steps can people do to reduce the ozone at home?
People can do such things at home like mowing their lawn or filling up their gas tank after 5 p.m. Also, when they're filling their gas tank, they need to stop at the clicking sound so they don't overfill their tank. Some other things are to use some low VOC household cleaning products and paints and solvents. Another thing that people can do is to consider getting an electric lawnmower or other electric lawn and garden tools.
Improving air pollution requires our attention and participation to have a healthy community. Even if you can only focus your efforts with your car will be a big help. By taking a few simple steps, we can all play a part in the air we breathe to live.
Reducing ozone can help with our quality of life because it will make it easier to breathe for all of us. We would have cleaner air. We all love our outdoors in Colorado, and we can be outdoors more often and not have to worry about harmful ground level ozone.
What is the Simple Steps Better Air Program?
The Simple Steps Better Air Program is a way that we're showing people in the Denver metro area how they can make their own impact on reducing ground level ozone. There are simple steps that we all can take to make our air quality better, and that's what we're talking to people about.